We are hearing about new catalytic converter thefts every single week. So many brazen thieves, not even caring if they're caught on camera. According to the King County Sheriff's Office, by the end of 2021, they were averaging 4 catalytic converter thefts every single day. And those are just the ones that are being reported.
So now 8 East King County police agencies, including the sheriff, are joining forces to go after these thieves. This is the legislature tries to make it more difficult to buy the stolen goods.
Fox 13's Matt Markovich breaks it down for us tonight.
Watch this. In one hand, the thief has a jack. In the other, a reciprocal saw, or sawzall as they're called. After jacking up the Prius, the guy with the sawzall crawls underneath and cuts out the catalytic converter in less than 90 seconds. They all leave with the converter in hand, and depending on the car and the precious metals inside, it could be worth up to $500. But it costs the vehicle's owner thousands of dollars to replace it.
It is clear this problem is not going away and not slowing down.
8 Eastside King County police agencies and the county sheriff announced the formation of a CatCon task force. That's the shorthand for catalytic converter, because thefts are growing and the threat of violence increasing.
We're finding thieves now are arming themselves with weapons. So it's clear we need to try and get a handle on this.
Bellevue has seen a 580% increase in CatCon thefts from 2020 to 2021. Police agencies have already made 11 arrests, including one just last week.
All the police departments talk really well together, and then we're all like one big team. We ended up finding some tattoos down the suspect's arm, according to the photo that I received. And when we contacted this male, he had the exact same tattoos all over his arms. It was a perfect match.
But there's still the matter of prosecution, because CatCon thefts are considered nonviolent crimes, and those arrested are not being accepted into the jail.
Many judges are unlikely to hold these low-level offenders for a property crime, so an arrest really is an inconvenience. They're back out on the street later that day or the next day.
In June, 2 men from Iowa were arrested in Kent trying to sell 800 stolen catalytic converters. County prosecutors here wanted to take the case, but the U.S. attorney in Iowa took the case, and now it's stalled with no court dates. Police want people to be aware of this sawing sound should you hear it coming from your driveway, and they suggest that people paint their converters orange and etch any number into the device so police can return it if your car is a CatCon victim.
Matt Markovich, Fox 13 News.